Hey guys, it's Ari. I haven't done a video in forever, and I know I always like, oh, I should do this video, blah, blah, blah. And then I don't do it because I'm really lazy. But anyways, so I decided yesterday at like 1 in the morning, I'm going to do my hair like Eleanor's. And so I was just like looking up pictures, and I found a picture, and so I copied it and I tweeted it. And apparently it looked decent. I don't know. Who knows? Anyways, so I decided maybe I should do a video on this. So that's what I'm doing. A video for Eleanor hair, makeup, and outfit. And yeah. So I hope you like it. And comment nice things. Don't see mean things. Like and subscribe. And I promise you, since it's summer, I will do more videos. I swear, I will do more. Because I've been a lousy YouTuber. So yeah, that's about it. Enjoy the video.
Okay, so first what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull back my hair because I don't like any makeup with my hair in my face. And so now I'm going to use my Garnier BB cream and put it on my face. It's kind of just like putting lotion on your face. You just want to give it that perfect skin look or whatever. Once you do that, you're going to set it with a Stay Matte by Rimmel, and I'm using sandstone. And you just apply that to your face just like any normal powder, and you go down so that way the hairs on your face, because everybody has them on their face, don't go up, and it gives it a more solid finish. Now afterwards, I'm going to use my Almay Wake Up for under eye concealer because everyone has bags under their eyes. So you're going to add that just a little bit because a little bit of that stuff goes a long way. Next we're going to do eyes, and we're going to start with eyeshadow. And I use the Natural Eye Palette by Too Faced. And the two colors that I used were Pillow Talk and Birthday Suit. You're going to apply Pillow Talk just to the eyelid, the entire eyelid. Then you're going to take Birthday Suit and put it into the corners. Then you're going to take Pillow Talk again and put it in your eyelid crease. Next, we're going to use the MAC Gel Eyeliner and an eyeliner brush to put the eyeliner on the top waterline. This is to make your eyes look bigger and fuller. Next, we're going to do the top eyeliner in just a little bit. It's going to be the Felt Tip Black Liquid Eyeliner by L'Oreal. I'm just going to swipe it across the top of your eyelid into one solid straight line. Very simple. Next, we're going to use the Buxom Mascara. This is my favorite mascara. And you're just going to put it on. To hair. So what I did first is I parted it in two sections. But make sure you have a middle part, because that's the key thing in this whole hairstyle. So you're going to take your first section. And you're going to use the Conair Curling Iron. Or not curling iron, curling wand. And you curl it away from your face, so that way it frames your face, and you definitely want to do that on the piece that's closer to your face. Once you get the pieces closer to your face curled away, you can start changing the way that you curl it. And so you can curl it in, so that way you get a bit of a variation and the curls don't stick together. You want to focus on curling the ends the most. Those are the most important part to curl. You don't really have to leave it very long. It depends on how thick your hair is. Some pieces I leave it longer than others. Sometimes I don't. So that's pretty much how you're going to curl the rest of your head. We're going to speed this up, but on the left side, you're going to do the same exact thing. You're going to curl away from your face on the inner pieces, and then you're going to go towards your face, or whichever you really feel like doing, on other pieces. But again, make sure you go away from your face when the curls are closer to your face, because one, you don't want to burn yourself, and two, it looks better. Now, you don't really have to worry about perfecting every piece right when you get it done on each section, because at the end, you can go back and pull pieces and recurl them. But that is your first section done. So now what I do is I separate the section so it's easier to curl the next one. So I'm going to put that section into a ponytail, and then I'm going to put down the other section. So on this section, I curled away from my face the entire time, because these are the ones that are really going to frame it and put the whole thing together. Plus, they go into the next step of the hairstyle, which is the bump. Now on the bangs, make sure you hold the curling iron up and tilted, so that way you can get the right shape, because bangs are really hard to curl. On the next side, we're going to do the same thing, curling away from the face. And you can really leave it there as long as you want. Like, there's no set time. Just make sure that you get the curl. But don't burn your hair like that one girl's video. Again, with the bangs, it's not going to be perfect the first time that you do it, but it's okay. Just keep curling them, because they'll eventually grab onto what you're trying to get them to do. So now that we finished the other layer, you can put down the other one, and you are almost done with doing your hair. Like I said before, you can fix up the pieces that didn't completely get curled once you put it all down. I did a lot of. Oops. Okay. So now we're going to move on to the bump. You're going to want to take the crown of your hair and put that up into a ponytail just for a few seconds, once you figure out how much you want to take. I'd say take about an inch from each side. Then you're going to want to put the hair that you're not going to be messing with in a side ponytail, and you're going to make it loose so that way you don't lose your curls, because my hair, it goes away the second I put it in a ponytail. So now you're going to let that down, and this is the hard part. This is where you're going to tease the crown of your hair. So what you do is you find the sections that you're going to want to tease. Because it's not a giant bump, it's just a little bump to give it some added volume. And then you're going to tease it down. You can do this with a hairbrush, a teasing comb, a normal comb, whichever you really feel like using, or whatever you have available. I just use my hairbrush. Now don't let the teasing scare you. It's kind of hard to figure out what you want to tease, but once you figure it out, it's not that hard. So just make sure you have the volume that you want. It can be a giant bump, it can be a small bump. I did a fairly small bump because I'm not a volume person. So once you get this figured out, you use a little hair clippy and you clip them down. So now you let down your other hair and you can curl pieces that you need to fix up, or you can call it done, whichever. Then you can hairspray it, and you are finished with your hair. Yeah! Now on to the outfit.